Thank you very much. I, on behalf of my party, the Muslim Women Protection Rights of Marriage Bill 2017, I stand here in support of the bill. But we definitely would like to make some suggestions and interventions. Sir, I come from a state which is an exceptionally progressive state of various saints and reformers. Maharashtra was the state where Shivaji was born. Shahu Maharaj led the reforms of women's education, women's equal rights, where women like Rajmata Jizau, Ahilyabai Holkar, Tara Rani, Chand Bibi, Savitribai Phule, Fatima B. Sheikh, Anandibai Joshi, Tarabai Shinde. It's been an endless long list of women who have got equal rights, be it in good governance, be in building our states, the nation, and they have been real pride to not just our state but to our nation. And true enough that what you said in your opening, sir, is true, that today it's not a bill just of making a legislation, it's an emotional bill for every woman in this nation, not just Muslim women, because those are also our sisters and our citizens, rightful citizens of this state. But sir, I just want to highlight something which is probably not appropriate for me to say, but I stand here representing men and women, but today I stand here as a woman, where I have to think even from my heart. And there are two or three interventions which the honorable member from the BJP Treasury said, which I thought was slightly objectionable, so if you could kindly clarify in your reply. She talked about triple talaq, which we are all against. I think the whole sense of the entire house is to send a clear message to the nation that this entire house supports you in objecting to triple talaq, but instant triple talaq. But I had a very small and a strange story to share with you, which happened to me day before yesterday at the Mumbai airport. I was standing in the queue for security and a lady called Saida Rukshana was standing ahead of me, and she started talking to me, and I asked her that, what is your view on instant triple talaq? So she turned around to me and said that the Supreme Court is anyway done. Why are you wasting your time on it? Why don't you give me equal justice on marital rape? I was aghast to see a woman. I'm so glad Menka ji is sitting right here when we are discussing such an important issue. And what I was surprised is when the Treasury Bench lead speaker talked about 141 and 142 in a speech. So she was actually contradicting what you said, sir. So I'm not an eminent lawyer. I'm not a lawyer. So I would be really happy. I'm a microbiologist by profession. So if you could clarify that 141 says that the law declared by the Supreme Court shall be binding on all courts within the territory. Yes. So I can't understand, then you were saying we need the law and she was quoting 141. So what is really the logic? I am slightly confused about what the stand of the government is. And this, my poor lady who I met at the airport seemed far more saner than all of us, because she said, why do we need it? Supreme Court has already done this. Why don't you go one step ahead and talk about marital rape? Because instant triple talaq has already been eradicated by the Supreme Court. So I would like, sir, for you to definitely say that. And another thing she said, that instant triple talaq of jail, I think everybody feels that every family dispute need not be criminalized. I mean, I should thank the Honorable Supreme Court on 27th of July, which what they have said is in the judge bench of Justice Goel and Justice UU Lalit, no automatic arrest in 498 cases, guidelines have been issued to police and magistrates. So when in a dowry case, because India is full of very complex social issues, be it female feticide, be it dowry, be it instant triple talaq, sir, we have all these issues. It doesn't really matter which, whether you're a Hindu or a Muslim or a Parsi or a Christian. There are deep-rooted challenges and social issues towards women. You don't really have to be born in. I was just blessed that I was born in a modern family where my parents chose to have, as they call it, the girl child. I have objection. We are not girl child. We are children, whether it's a girl or a boy. But I was not born in a society there. But there are very complex issues of women, and not even just. Female feticide is an issue which is even in educated cities and educated families. So I don't think we can really isolate one community in this. That really would be injustice to all. I think what you really need to look at the larger picture, like dowry, is we made a great ruling and you get arrested. But has dowry stopped? It hasn't. And the courts are saying now that I think it's too harsh and it gets misused and there's more harassment in it. So really, I understand the deterrent. I appreciate and respect your intervention by saying the 3 years is a must. It will be a deterrent. But sir, has dowry stopped? It hasn't been a deterrent. And now the Honorable Supreme Court is saying that in dowry, when we talked about arrest in 498A, unfortunately, they are saying we should dilute it and the police and the magistrate should not look at instant arrest. So will the same thing happen for instant triple talaq is something we all need to discuss, because I think it's really critical. Because I don't think arresting, and even the same, the Treasury bench member said that there can be reconciliation. Sir, who says so? Court can't intervene everywhere. We come from a culture where if a husband and wife fight, the first thing should be send them to family court. Why can't the marriage be re-looked at? So instead of sending him to court, why can't that couple have good counselors? Why can't we have interventions maybe from reformers? Like in Maharashtra, we have kirtankars. Like the social change. Like in the Muslim community, I think there are ulemas. So ulemas and kirtankars, why can't they all, sorry? Darur khazar. Why can't we get them on board? Because social changes, sir, don't happen just with legislation. I think social change comes when all of us put our, be it the media, be it legislation, be it reformers, all these people together have to work to make social change. So I would urge you that marriages can be reworked out, counselors can play a critical role, we all know. And the biggest problem is when you put a father in court, he may be a bad husband, but he could be a wonderful father. And when the father comes out, that child will be ragged every day in school and said, "Tumhara baap jail mein hai." Does that child, what is that child's mistake? The child is not born out of choice and could be just a domestic issue case or a domestic violence. So why aren't we considering family courts instead of jail? Are we here to break marriages or are we here to reconcile them? And that's how India society is. And one divorce in a family is not isolated. We don't live such nuclear families. The whole family gets affected. So if you're going to criminalize, the whole family is going to get harassed and trouble. The mother, and look at the woman, she will put the husband in jail. He's not going to come back and hug her and kiss her and say, "I'm sorry." So why don't we look for a better solution where he could apologize, he could be counseled, and she could live in a less hostile environment. Because no woman wants to leave. No woman in this world, however badly she is, she first wants her marriage to work because she wants to protect her children. Her children are her first choice. And then she will worry about her husband. So I think you really need to look at this legislation not just as a landmark flag in your one of your achievements, but something holistically from the heart. Because this nation also needs legislation from the heart. Because coming to digital India, it's sometimes I feel it's sometimes terrible, sir. I hate to say this in front of you, but the personal touch with so much digitization has really gone. I don't want marriages and relationships to be just reached into digital India and get lost and lose out on the personal emotional touch of relationships, which India is so proud of in our culture and our heritage. So I appeal to you to reconsider this. We are with you. We support what you're saying. And I respect your deterrent clause, but I think when it comes to a marriage, I think the deterrent clause needs to be thought with the heart, also with the brain. Thank you very much.